Hello, welcome to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge. And in our previous videos, we have already discussed java.lang object class, few methods, that is toString method, clone method, equals, hash code, finalize, and get class methods. And today in this video, we will discuss its all remaining methods, that is wait, notify, and notify all methods. And why we need wait method? Because it causes the current thread to wait until another thread invoke the notify or notify all function for the same object that we have locked. And these are the signatures of wait method: public final void wait, and it is zero parameter. And another function is public final void wait. Here we can pass time in millisecond. And this is the third one, and here we can pass two parameter. One is time in milliseconds and along with nanoseconds. And what is notify and notify all methods? And these are the two methods: public final void notify. If we want to wake up a single thread that is waiting on the same object, so we can call notify function. If we want to notify multiple threads at a time, then we can use notify all function. So let's create one program and we'll understand how this wait and notify execute and work. So here I will create one class, that is wait notify example. These wait, notify, and notify all methods are available in object class. So if a thread wants to call wait, notify, and notify all methods, then compulsory the thread should be owner of the object. That is, the thread has to get the lock of that object. So we can use wait, notify, and notify all. So hence we can call wait, notify, notify all these three functions only from synchronized area. Otherwise we will get runtime exception saying illegal monitor state exception. So we must use synchronized block here. So here I will create one more class, that is class task executor, that will extends thread class, and in this class I will override run method, and here in this method here I will execute one task that will start from int I is equal to 1 and I up to 10. So it will print the value from 1 to 10. So here I will use system.out.println, and here the output will be print, that is I. So when this task will be complete and it will be finish iteration from 1 to 10, then this child thread will send the notification to parent thread or any other thread. And how it will send notification? Here it will call, so here if we want to notify the another thread, so we must need to use synchronized block, because without synchronized we cannot execute wait notify function. So here I will paste it here, and here it will lock, get the lock of object. So this is a current object, and here it will call the notify function. And now I will go to second class, and here I will create one thread, that is our main thread. So here I will create the object for task class, So here I will create one object task is equal to new task, and here I will call task dot start method. When I will call this function, it will automatically invoke to the run method of another class. So here I will use synchronized block, and inside this synchronized block I will call to wait method. So here I will just print the statement trying to call wait method, and here I will call task dot wait, and here I will use this function, and here I will pass 1000 millisecond means 1 second, and here I will just print one more statement. If it will go to notification, main thread got notification, then this will execute. And here we need to handle the exception, that is interrupted exception. And now when I will execute this program, first our main thread will be start to execute, and it will create the object for this. And when I will call task.start function, then automatically there is run function will be execute, and it will process iteration, then it will print 10 times, and after completing the iteration it will print this statement, and then it will call this dot notify all, and all the remaining threads that will be in the waiting state start to execute, and then this statement will be print. So first this statement will print, and after that this task will complete its iteration, and after completing the iteration this statement will be print, and then it will call this dot notify all, and after that in last this statement will be print, because after calling notify all function waiting state thread will be execute. Now I will run this application and we'll check the output. So here we can see first trying to call wait method execute, and thread will be entered into waiting state for 1 second, and during this time this iteration completed, and then child thread sending the notification to main thread, and it's calling this dot notify all function, and when this function will be invoked, automatically waiting state thread will be start execution, and then main thread got the notification. Here we can use notify function also. If we can use notify to notify only one state, one waiting thread, but which waiting thread will be notified we cannot expect exactly, and all other remaining threads have to wait for other notification. But in the case of notify all case, all the remaining threads will be notifying, but the threads will be executed one by one. And these are the three methods that we have discussed: wait, notify and notify all functions. And we can use wait, notify and notify all function only inside synchronized area, because on which object we are calling wait, notify and notify all, we have to get the lock of that object, then only it will be invoked. Okay, thanks for watching this video.